Hey gang, Jack Lair here, and I just want to talk about going home.
Hi mom, so I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so love you, see you soon, bye.
It's a video game that came out in 2013, and it was, I don't know, kind of kicked around for being a walking simulator. And I think it gets a lot of flack for that. But it's one of those type of games where I am always intrigued to just walk around a space, to be there. For those of you who don't know, basically the story is about a 21-year-old named Katie who comes home from a trip in Europe to find out that basically what's happened is while she's been gone, her parents and her younger sister, who is 17, have moved. An uncle who had a big house died and left them the house, so they moved in. The father is a failed writer, wrote a novel about someone who time traveled to save JFK, from what I gather from the books. And these are all little spoilers for the game, because this is the setup for it. And you basically come home after being gone, and no one's home, so you have to find the key to get into the door, and then you listen to the messages, and the messages are the last message on the phone is from you saying, "Don't worry, I'll get a ride home," which you did. And that starts the investigation of what's going on? Why is no one here? And you do find out, and I won't ruin the answers, but there's a whole lot that happens in this game, and it can only happen at a certain time point. It's a period piece, if you will. If you're 1995 is a period piece. And the reason that it resonates so much with me is that I graduated from high school in 1995.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties: Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County, Takelma County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected as...
For me, in my life, I joined the Army 2 years later. And I go off to see the world, basically. At that point in time, cell phones are a thing, but they're not really widespread. I had a pager because it was cheap enough for my mom to be able to beep me and say, "Come home right now," or "There's an emergency." And that was basically it. That was a source of communication outside of the house, because there was no Wi-Fi, there was no cell phone for anything that we could get. And no one I knew owned a laptop at that point. Every computer had giant CRTs sitting on desks that were made of laminated particle board. And it was an amazing time. And this video game is set in that small window. Now, if this sounds intriguing, if exploring it is what you want to do, I beg you, please, go play it. Because now, I'm going to start spoiling some stuff. And I'm going to spoil everything. The main thing is that Katie comes home, everybody's gone. Your parents' relationship has fallen apart. The dad is no longer writing. He used to write, he was a novelist, and now he is writing reviews for VCRs. There is your sister dealing with the fact that you are now gone. Her big sister is not there. And you are traveling through Europe, so she can't communicate with you. So she writes everything down in letters to you that you hear in audio throughout the game.
We moved into this house. I'm at a new school. And my big sister being gone for a year doesn't make it any easier.
Basically, here's what happens. She's interested in Lonnie, hanging out with Lonnie. And Lonnie is a rebel, anti-authoritarian, and joins the military, which, that was me. I am not a traditionalist. If something is a tradition, I want to know why. Why do we put up a tree? Why do we put up the lights? Why do we have turkey? Cooking turkey is so hard. We could just have a ham and everybody would be happier. But that's me. In this game, Sam, your younger sister, lies to her parents and goes away to a concert. Has the time of her life. And spends the night, and they start getting romantically involved. Sam's a lesbian. Today, for most of the people I interact with, that's an okay, and move on. But in 1995, that was a different story. And it tells that story, and it goes through the process of, okay, well, the relationship is frowned upon. What do we do? And there's a list in there where she's like, okay, here are the options. We can make out and people won't freak out. I now know that I had friends at the time that were going through that. And there's a part in there where she talks about having the talk.
I had an interesting talk with Mom and Dad tonight. One you were never gonna need to have.
And she says flat out, she's like, look, I expected.
I was prepared for them to be mad or disappointed or start crying or something, but they were just in denial.
And as a father, now that hurts. That the thought that one of my kids would come to me and be like, look, this is how I feel. And I would be like, nah, you're too young. You don't know how you feel. That hurts. And the parents did that out of hand. They're like, ah, it's just a phase. And she says, like,
I mean, you've known, right? I've known. I've known since, like, She-Ra.
This has always been a thing.
Well, joke's on them. Because they're in for one very long phase.
You go through a lot of this, and it is... So Lonnie is in ROTC, and her family is a military family. My family is a military family. I identify with Lonnie in this scenario. And basically, the day after graduation, she's going to go to basic training. And odds are she will never see Sam again. Because there are friends that once I moved away the first time, I never saw them again. Because coming back, they had moved, we had lost phone numbers. Keep in mind, no cell phones, internet is barely a thing. People are changing their email addresses depending on who's giving free hours of internet. Because this is the point where they're charging you to access the internet by the hour. So it's not really a thing. So they think, both of them think that this is the end. And Lonnie gets on the bus and disappears. And then Sam is obviously heartbroken that her first love, the love of her life, is gone. She wakes up and there is Lonnie, saying, you know, I got on the bus and I was going to go to basic training, which you would go to in processing first, but that's inside baseball nonsense. But so she got on the bus and then realized that she was making a mistake. And then got off the bus and came to Sam. And basically, the as you're looking throughout the house, you find all of these missing, like, there are AV jacks just sticking out, or RCA cables, I guess, just sticking out all over the place under TVs. And it's because she has stolen all of the VCRs to pawn, I guess, to go live their life together, which, I mean, it's kind of the happy outcome of Romeo and Juliet. Another thing that she mentions is she's like, I never thought.
Lonnie brought her hair dye over today. She said, I need to fix these roots. Think you could help? Dyeing hair is weirdly intimate.
And it is. And that's one of the reasons why I still wash my wife's hair. Because it is a time for us to just be us. And for me to take care of her. Sorry if that's too much information. But anyways, so going back, the other things that locked us in that time frame is that just before I went into the military, so around 1995, I was taken to places that were hole in the wall. Calling them a theater is being very nice. They were basically just a giant empty room, and right next to it was the first coffee shop I ever went to. So the first time I had coffee that was not like drip coffee at a diner or whatnot. There are some mixtapes, but there are also just straight up tape copies. Because once again, there's no internet. They're living in Oregon somewhere in a made up place, which if the made up place in Oregon is anything like the place that I grew up, which is farm country, there was no music store. So if it was not carried by the local Kmart, or it was sold by, oh, what's the name of the thing? Nobody remembers. But they charge you, and then they send it to you, and then, I can't remember. Whatever. But you couldn't get these different sounds. So unless you knew somebody that went there and bought something at a concert, you didn't know they existed. But I was a late bloomer musically. Some would argue still am. But that's why playing this game that took me an hour and a half gave me so many thoughts. Because this was enough of the pieces of the life that I knew at that time to be a weird little time capsule. As far as the parents go, they are off on a marriage counseling retreat to try and work better on their marriage, which I think if they can, like, the little clues that are left around, like the mom got taken out to a concert by a coworker, which is always a little, and supposedly he's really dreamy because Jan wants to meet him. Jan is a friend of mom's? No. Other way around. My brain just died. And that probably means I should end this because it's going on way too long. But I hope that if what I just said sounds interesting and you want to explore and follow the bread trails into my memories, and if you're an emotional person like me, have some Kleenex handy, because it's a lot. But that'll do it for me. I want to thank you very much for watching, and as always, play on.